From the chapter Safeguarding the Noble Quran, narrated Abu Musa al-Ashri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, retain, commit to memory and safeguard the Noble Quran by the one in whose hand Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's soul is. It escapes sooner from memory than a camel does from its tying ropes. Muttafiq alayhi. To safeguard the Noble Quran means to recite it regularly, because if one fails to do so, he tends to forget it quickly. In fact, in the absence of regular recitation, one is bound to forget it more quickly than a camel breaks the string it is bound with. The breaking of the string by the camel to liberate itself is a smile for the quick process of forgetting. Narrated Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the parable of one who knows the Noble Quran by heart is as the parable of an owner of hobbled camel. If he remains vigilant, he will retain it, and if he neglects it, it will go away. Rawahul Bukhari wa Muslim. This hadith repeats the subject mentioned above. The person who remembers the entire Quran or a portion of it, if continues its recitation, he will retain it. Otherwise, it will start slipping from his memory. The simile used here is very apt, because if one keeps a strict watch on the camel, it will remain tied to the tether. But no sooner is it freed, then it runs away with such a speed that it becomes difficult to find and capture. The merit of recitation of the Noble Quran in present voice. Narrated Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I heard Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Allah does not listen so attentively to anything as He listened to the recitation of the Noble Quran by a prophet who recites well with a melodious and audible voice. Rawahul Bukhari wa Muslim. Allah does not listen so attentively has twofold meanings. First, Allah's acceptance and pleasure. Second, His ears and the quality of hearing. One must have faith in this, although we can neither describe it nor compare it with anything else. The word ghina is ordinarily used for singing, but here it does not have the sense of recitation with artificial voice, as is being done by many modern qari. What it actually means is the recitation which is done in accordance with principle of the tajweed and in a voice which comes out of the depth of feelings and is touching. This hadith induces us to recite the Noble Quran with depth of feeling and good voice. But one must take utmost care that there is no variation in the utterances of the Quranic letters. Narrated Abu Musa al-Ashri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, you have been given a mizmar, sweet melodious voice, out of the mazammir of the family of Prophet Dawood alayhi salam. Rawahul Bukhari and Muslim. Mizmar means musical instrument like flute, but here it stands for tune and sweet voice. In the phrase Al Dawood, translated here, the
close the door, please.
Family of Dawood. The word Al is superfluous, and what is in fact meant is Prophet Dawood, because none in his family was endowed with sweet voice except him. In any case, sweet voice is a gift of Allah, who grants it to whom He likes. Lucky indeed are those who are granted this gift and they go about using it to invite people to the religion of Allah, and do not use it for making money and spreading evil, which has a sad end. Narrated Al-Bara' bin Azib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I heard Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting Surah Wat-Teen Waz-Zaytun during the Isha prayer. I have never heard any anyone reciting it in a more delightful voice than this. Rawahu al-Bukhari wa Muslim. This hadith tells us that like other virtues and qualities, the Prophet ﷺ was also granted a sweet voice by Allah, and he certainly needed it for his mission. Narrated Abu Lubabah Bashir bin Abdul Munaddil radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah's Messenger ﷺ said, "He who does not recite the noble Quran in a pleasant tone is none of us." Abu Dawud. The word "is none of us" means that he is not following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam with regard to the recitation of the Quran. This hadith also induces us to recite the Quran with a sweet, touching voice and with a depth of feeling, because the recitation of the Quran in this manner enhances its effect. Narrated Ibn Masud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me, "Recite the noble Quran to me." I said, "O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, shall I recite it to you whereas it was revealed to you?" He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I like to hear it from others." Then I began to recite Surah An-Nisa. When I reached the verse, "How will it be when we shall bring a witness from every people and bring you as a witness against them?" Having heard it, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, enough. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, enough. When I turned my look towards him, I found his eyes were overflowing with tears. Rawahu al-Bukhari wa Muslim. This hadith has been mentioned earlier. It is repeated here for the reason that it has an aspect of honor of the people who are blessed with knowledge and grace. Moreover, it stresses the need to hear the recitation of the Quran from those who recite it beautifully in order to contemplate over it, as was done by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam himself.
Jazakallah khair.